Today we are going to learn about reproduction in organism. In last class, we studied that why there is need of reproduction. As we know that reproduction is very time consuming and energy consuming process, but still there is a need of reproduction because we know that there are so many species. There are so many species. Okay, like elephant is a species and rose is a species, crow is a species. Okay, so what happens that generally, what happens that every species has a limited lifespan, or every individual, okay, has a limited lifespan. What is lifespan? From birth to death. Okay, so the duration is known as lifespan. Now, when every individual die, okay, what happened when each and every individual die? When each and every individual die, okay, there is a we cannot find any species. Suppose that there was an elephant 500 years ago. After 75 years of its lifespan, the elephant died. Okay. Now we are not able to find another elephant, but due to the process of reproduction during its lifespan of 75 years, this elephant is able to produce new elephant before it died. So we have new elephant, and this elephant starts its own lifespan, and during this lifespan, which is approximately 75 years, this elephant will produce new individual in this lifespan before it dies. It produces new elephant. So it produces new elephant before it dies. So what happens that when any individual or any organism dies, it produces new individual of same kind. Any organism has limited lifespan, and after lifespan, every individual dies and it produces new individual before it dies. Okay, so this new individual is able to produce another individual before it die. So it will produce another new individual. So there is a generation to generation production, or we can say reproduction. First generation produces second generation, and second generation produces third generation, and third generation produces fourth generation. So generation by generation, when organism, it produces new organism before it dies. It produces new organism before it dies. So this is the need of reproduction, that there is a continuity, or there is a need of continuity, and every organism needs to survive, or every species needs to survive. Not every organism, every species needs to survive, and this is only possible because of reproduction. Okay, so we can say, what is reproduction? To produce new individuals of same kind before death or during lifespan. For maintenance of any, for maintenance of new species. For maintenance of species, for maintenance of species. Okay, so there are various type of individuals and various type of organism, and Due to this, every organism or every species has a different pattern of reproduction. Various patterns are there, and there are various patterns of reproduction. So various species or individual have various patterns of reproduction. So generally, there are two basic patterns of reproduction, and these two basic patterns are known as two patterns. Okay, so it is asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. So generally, on our planet, each and every individual follow either asexual reproduction method or sexual reproduction method. Now, for understanding that how asexual or sexual reproduction takes place, we have to learn about types of cell division so that we will clarify that how reproduction takes place, either asexual or sexual. So first of all, we have to learn about types of cell division. Then we can understand reproduction in better way. Types of cell division. There are three types of cell division. First is amitosis. Second is mitosis. And third one is meiosis. First of all, let's start with amitosis. What is amitosis? Amitosis generally occurs in Monera or bacteria. In this type of reproduction pattern, this is a bacterial cell. And in bacterial cell, generally we know that there is no nucleus. Instead of nucleus, there is nucleoid. So this region is actually known as nucleoid. So what happens that, and this is cytoplasm. In this type of cell division, amitosis, there is no formation of chromosome. You know what is chromosome? When a cell is supposed to divide, this is a cell and this is nucleus. This is known as chromatin thread. So when a cell is supposed to divide, chromatin thread converts into these rod-like structures, and these rod-like structures are known as chromosome. So in amitosis, there is no formation of chromosome, and what happens that when these chromosomes are formed inside a cell, first of all, chromatin thread convert into chromosome and the chromosomes are formed. And chromosomes are pulled by these thread-like structures, which is known as spindle fiber. Okay, so what happens that they pull, spindle fiber pulls chromosome at two different poles, and finally, what happens? Half of the chromosome goes to this side and half chromosome goes to this side. Okay, now there are two cell. This one cell is divided into B and C, and suppose that A is having 46 number of chromosome, or so A is having 46 number of chromosome, so B and C is also having 23 number of chromosome. Okay, so I will discuss this later on with you in mitosis. So right now, okay, my main aim to make you understand that there is formation of chromosome and there is formation of spindle fibers. Spindle fibers pull, actually they pull chromosome. Spindle fibers pull chromosome. They pull chromosome. They pull chromosome in at two different poles. Okay, you can write north and south pole. So there is a pulling. Now, in amitosis, there is no pulling, and finally, there is no formation of chromosome. no chromosome form out of this chromatin genetic material. There is no formation of chromosome. Chromosome never appears. And same time, there is no formation of spindle fiber so that they can pull chromosome. Spindle fibers are important so that they can pull chromosome at two different poles. So finally, there is no spindle fiber. So a cell generally divides in two cell. A is dividing into two cell. Cytoplasm and nuclear material, okay, it is dividing, but without formation of chromosome and spindle fiber. This type of cell division is known as amitosis. It generally takes place in bacteria and monera. Now we are having another type of cell division, and which is known as mitosis. In mitosis, suppose this is a cell. Now mitosis takes place in all eukaryotes. In mitosis, this is cell and this is nucleus. It is having chromatin thread. When a cell supposed to divide, this chromatin thread get convert into chromosome. Chromosomes are rod-like structures. Now, I want to tell you one more thing that in human beings, this is our nucleus and we are having chromatin thread. Chromatin thread is made up of DNA and protein. When a cell supposed to divide, and where we are having chromatin thread 2.2 meter long. So when cell supposed to divide, this chromatin thread converts into rod-like structure, which are known as chromosome. Now we are having actually 46 chromosome out of 2.2 meter long chromatin thread. Our cell makes 46 chromosome. So 46 chromosomes are in pair. Okay, so these chromosomes are in pair. So actually there are 23 pairs. We are having 46 chromosome, and 46 chromosomes are arranged in pair. So we are having 23 pairs of chromosome. Now, in mitosis cell division, generally this is a resting cell. This cell is not the cell which is having chromatin thread of 2.2 meter length. This cell is normal cell and it is not going under any division. Now I'm telling about cell which is about to divide. So first of all, what happens that this cell is doubling its chromatin thread, and there is doubling of chromatin thread. So 2.2 meter long chromatin thread converts into 4.4 meter long chromatin thread, first of all. Now, as we have 46 chromosome, the number of chromosome never changes. I will show you the photo of chromosome. This is the photo of chromosome. You can see we are having 23 pair. You can count 23 pair. You can count. This is last one, 23 pair, and totally we are having 46 chromosome. So this 46 chromosomes are chromosome when a cell is not dividing. But when our cell is dividing, what happens? There is a bit change that chromatin thread get double from 2.2 meter to 4.4 meter, and we are having 46 chromosome. Okay, this is one pair, this is second pair, this is third pair, this is fourth pair. I'm not able to draw all chromosome here. Now, they are in pair, you can see 1A and 1B, 2A and 2B, 3A and 3B. Now what happens that in a cell which is about to divide, okay, this is for normal cell, the number 2.2 meter and 46 chromosome in 23 pair. This is for a cell which is not dividing. When a cell supposed to divide, as we are learning about mitosis, when chromatin thread doubles, okay, so the number of chromosome never changes, or pair never changes. The number of chromosome is same, that is 46, and pair are also not going to change. Okay, there is only double loading. What is double loading? 46 क्रोमोसोम लोड्स अमाउंट ऑफ 92 क्रोमोसोम. 46 क्रोमोसोम लोड्स अमाउंट 46 क्रोमोसोम लोड अमाउंट 492 क्रोमोसोम्स. रिमेंबर दिस थिंग्स दैट वी आर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आवर सेल इज हैविंग 2.2 मीटर लॉन्ग क्रोमेटिन थ्रेड. व्हेन अ सेल सपोज टू डिवाइड इट डबल्स क्रोमेटिन थ्रेड from 2.2 meter to 4.4 meter, you can see. Now, our chromosome number never get changed. 46 number of chromosome and 23 pair of chromosome is our identity of Homo sapiens, of humans. It will never get changed. But what about this number? Okay, what about the length of chromatin thread, which has doubled? So you can see that 46 chromosome holds or loads amount for 92 chromosomes. So you can see that it is only one pair, or you can see it is two chromosome. One pair means two chromosome, but you can see that they are doubly loaded. I loaded them. Okay. So they are doubly loaded. You can see that they are doubly loaded with this green color. Okay. Red color is for non-loaded, unloaded chromosome, and green color is for, they are doubly loaded. So they cover 46 chromosome loads amount for 92 chromosome. Now what happens? This is cell. Okay, this is just nucleus. Okay, I'm not going to draw. Okay, just let's draw whole cell. So we are having one pair of chromosome, second pair of chromosome, third pair of chromosome, fourth pair of chromosome. We are having total 46. So these are four chromosome. I'm not drawing 46 here. And every chromosome is doubly loaded. So remember this thing, that 46 chromosome loads amount for 92 chromosome because it is double. This is for mitosis. Okay, we are going to learn about mitosis. Now, this cell get divided and cytoplasm also get double. Cytoplasm also get double. Now this cell divide into two part. So we know that it is double, okay, double amount. So what happened, that half part, okay, they are 46 chromosome, but loaded with 92, loaded, the 46 chromosome are having chromatin thread or material for 92 chromosome. The number 46 remains same. Remember that number will never change. I can read this number one pair. I can read this number as two pair, three pair, four pair. Okay, pairs are not changing. Number of chromosome is not changing. It is same. Number of chromosome is never going to change. If the number of chromosome change, then you will be some another species. It is never going to change, but the amount is double. Remember this thing. Now what happens, that half amount will go here. So you can see that in 46 chromosome, I only drew four. I'm not able to do 46 here. So what happens, that 46 chromosomes are having amount for 92 chromosome. Now what happens, that 46 chromosome goes here and 46 chromosome goes here, or amount for 46 chromosome goes here and amount for 46 chromosome goes here in two cell, A cell and B cell. Now after cell division, both of them will again form chromatin fiber or chromatin thread. You can see that chromatin fiber or chromatin thread, both of them will form. Okay, and when both of them supposed to divide, they will double their material, and the process will repeat. Okay, now cytoplasm is also get double, and there is division of cytoplasm. It also get double, and there is division of cytoplasm also. So this is known as mitosis. Now, what is the specialty of mitosis? We started from 46, and number of chromatin thread get amount of chromatin thread get double for two cells, and finally it ends up with 46 and 46. It ends up with 46 and 46. So we can say that as it start, it ended, and there is no reduction division. We can say that there is no reduction. There is no reduction. There is no reduction division. So every cell of our body, every cell, eyes, nose, kidney, ear, lung, tongue, every cell divides in same pattern, which is known as mitosis, start with 46 and cell divide, ends with two cell. One cell start with 46 chromosome and it ends with two cell, and both of them are having 46 number of chromosome. Now, this type of pattern, every individual is having a number of chromosome. So I told you that there are 46 chromosome. Okay, and 46 chromosome can be loaded or cannot be loaded depending on the situation that cell is going to divide or cell is not going to divide. 46 chromosome are loaded with 92 chromosome, but the number of chromosome never get changed. It is 46 and it is always 46, either it is loaded or not. Loading is only when a cell is supposed to divide. Now 46 chromosomes are having 23 pair. Okay, so I can write 23 pair. I can write 46 as 23 pair, or I can write 46 as 2 into 23. Can I write this? Yes, I can write this. So this 23 is actually known as haploid number. It is known as haploid number, and this 46 is known as diploid number. Diploid number. So I can write 46 as diploid number. It is double. Diploid means double. As diploid number. And I can say this 23 as haploid number. And if I multiply 23 with 2, okay, so it is known as pair of chromosome. We are having 23 pair of chromosome, haploid and diploid number. For diploid number, for 46, I can use 2n, and for 23, I can use n. You know that if 23 is n, if I multiply it by 2, then it will be 46. So I can use n for 23. If I multiply it by 2, it will be 46, or it will be 2n. You can understand this. So we are having 23 pair of chromosome. 23 pair. Okay, the 2 stands for pair. So we are having 23 pair of chromosome, or 46 chromosome. Total we are having 46 chromosome. And we are having 46 chromosome. And we are having 23 pair. Now 23 stands for haploid number. Remember 23 alone. Okay, what is the meaning of 23? Meaning of 23 pair. Pair is 446. Now, if I write this, this is known as my double number of chromosome or diploid number of chromosome. That is original number. And if I write this, this is known as haploid number. Half number is known as haploid. I can represent 46 as 2n, and I can represent 23 as n. And if I multiply it by 2, it will be 2n. So this is haploid and diploid number. Now, another type of cell division is meiosis. In meiosis, there is a unique feature. Everything is same. This is chromatin thread. This chromatin thread again divide in same pattern. Chromatin thread produces chromosome. And 2.2 meter long chromatin thread can produce 46 chromosomes. So when cell supposed to divide, it will get double. And 2.2 meter long chromatin thread produces 4.4 meter long chromatin thread after doubling. And we are having 46 chromosome, but the 46 chromosome are loaded with amount of 92 chromosome. Okay, don't confuse with this. It is only when cell supposed to divide. So every time we are having when a cell supposed to divide, these are cell and they get, this is pair. It is pair and this is pair. Now I'm drawing only 4 pair here. And this is normal. This is for normal cell. And when a cell is supposed to divide, they are loaded. The chromosomes are loaded with 46 chromosomes are loaded with amount of 92 chromosomes. Sorry. Now in meiosis, there is a bit different from mitosis, that instead of forming two cells. It start with 46, it get double, it is loaded with amount of 92 chromosome. Then instead of making two cell, it will form four cell. It will form four cell, and every cell is having 23 number of chromosome. So if every cell is having 23 number of chromosome, the cell is haploid cell, or the cell is N cell. So every cell is having only 23 number of chromosome instead of 46. So in one cell is producing four cell. One cell is producing four cell. Remember this. Now this is for meiosis. So this type of pattern, meiosis, never occurs in every random cell of your body. Actually, meiosis occurs in some specific organs, both male and female. This is female and male. Okay, mother and father, both of them are having, or every human being is having, some special type of cell which are known as gametes. So gametes are only produced in organs which are known as reproductive organs. Only gametes are formed after meiosis. Remember that meiosis, a cell division only for production of gametes. Every cell of your body, eyes, nose, kidney, lung, tongue, bone, hair, every cell goes under the process of mitosis, and some organisms use mitosis for reproduction. But meiosis is something when a cell is having haploid number of 23 chromosome. So generally you are having 46 number of chromosome. Generally you are having 46 number of chromosome. When a cell is supposed to divide, you are having 46 chromosome, which is loaded with the amount of 92 chromosome. And again, it will divide into two cell, 46 and 46. So 46 is your identity number, or your species number, that every human being is having 46 number of chromosome. But a special cell in body which are able to produce new individual, so this cell go under meiosis process. Okay, so they went under meiosis process, and meiosis, you know, out of one cell which is having 46 number of chromosome, it get loaded and it will form four cells of 23 23 23 23 and 23 23 23 and 23. So these all cells are haploid, and haploid cells inside your body is known as gamete. Haploid cells inside your body known as gamete. So mother is having, or female is having, gamete known as ova, and father is having gamete known as sperm. And both of them, ova and sperm, both of them are known as gametes. And when they fuse, okay, so 23 number, or the cell which are having 23 number, are also known as N number. The 23 is N number, and the cells are haploid cell. Actually, they are haploid. Why they are haploid? Because they are having half number of chromosome. So both of them, gametes, are actually haploid. Remember, gametes are haploid. So when two gametes fuses, okay, 23 and 23, or N plus N, they will produce new individual or new human being with 46 number of chromosome. And each and every cell of our body, every cell of our body is having 46 number of chromosome. So when a cell is dividing, not dividing, we have 46 number of chromosome. When our cell is dividing, we are having 46 number of chromosome. The number is never going to change. And it is loaded with double amount of chromatin thread, which is 92, and again ends up with 46 and 46. So meiosis is actually known as reduction division. Meiosis is actually known as reduction division. It reduces the number of chromosome from 46 to NNN, and it is important pattern for sexual reproduction. Remember that those organisms who prefer sexual reproduction goes for meiosis, only for production of gametes. Remember, like human, only gametes form inside human being. Gametes are formed by meiosis. Other than this, every cell of our body go under mitosis. But only when we produce gametes, humans, only when we produce gametes, it produced by meiosis. So meiosis is also known as reduction division, and it is very important process so that mother and father can produce a new human being when gametes produce jointed, or they come together. So this is how new individual is formed. So now you know that there are three type of cell division, and mitosis, and meiosis. According to this, asexual reproduction is a mode of reproduction in which only one parent is involved. Only one parent is involved. So one parent doesn't need any another partner. So suppose that this is one parent and it is having 2n number. It never goes under reduction division and it undergoes in mitosis. So in mitosis, there is no reduction division and it can produce offspring or another generation which are having 2n number of chromosomes. Suppose it is having 20 number of chromosomes, it goes under mitosis. Mitosis is responsible for production of same number of chromosomes. And new individuals are 2n. So new individuals are actually having 20 number of chromosomes or 20 number of chromosomes. So new individuals are exactly same, actually same as their parent, but or asexual reproduction. And some organism follows mitosis for that. And some organism follow amitosis for that. In both of these cases, mitosis and amitosis, they don't need to search for a partner because the number of chromosomes are same. The number of chromosomes is never going to change, as you can see here. In mitosis, number never changes as it start, as it end. Okay, so what happens? That number never going to change. And in amitosis also, it is another pattern of division in which chromosome never forms, but number of chromosome never changes. Number of chromosome remains same. So offspring produces is just like parent. This is offspring, and offspring is same as parent. But what happens in meiosis or sexual reproduction? In sexual reproduction, you know that two individuals are involved, mother and father, and both of them produces NN. So some special cell, okay, for sexual reproduction, both of them need a partner for reproduction. So a special type of cell, which are known as gamete. Now, you know that gametes are only formed when there is meiosis. You know that because only meiosis is able to form, gametes, or meiosis is able to form haploid number or half number of chromosome. So what happened? That mother is having half number of chromosome. Suppose that in any type of species, mother is having 40 number of chromosome and father is also having 40 number of chromosome. So gametes are having actually 20 number of chromosome. And when both of the gamete come together, they will form 20 plus 20 and they will form 14, a new individual, which is having 40 number of chromosome. So for sexual reproduction, there is a need of meiosis, remember. For sexual reproduction, there is a need of meiosis. What meiosis does? Meiosis reduces number of chromosome. Meiosis reduces number of chromosome. So if number of chromosome reduces, half number of chromosome needs another half number of chromosome. So it can get a full number, 40. Remember this thing. And mitosis is a non-reduction division. And there is no need of partner because as it start, it ends. So in the offspring is same like parent, and there is no search of partner. There is no need to search any partner because if parent is having 46 number of chromosome, the daughter cells are also having 46 number of chromosome. They don't need any partner to maintain this number. So, and in asexual reproduction, they need partner so that they can complete their criteria. Every individual is having a specific number of chromosomes. So we can write here that in asexual reproduction, when there is no need of partner, individual follow amitosis and individual follows mitosis. Because in both of these patterns, there is no reduction division. There is no reduction division and the number of chromosome is same as parent. If parent is having 46 number of chromosome, it ends up with 46 number of chromosomes. So there is no need to search partner because identity maintains. Every species having a specific number of chromosomes. Now, for sexual reproduction, individual follow meiosis, and meiosis is followed by only some special cells or special organs perform meiosis, special organs like testes and ovary are having some special cell which goes under meiosis, and in meiosis there is reduction and the number of chromosome get half. So when it start with 46, it ends up with 23. Now when it ends up with 23, what happens that it needs another partner so that, or another cell, so that it can mate with another cell and it can manage the original number, which is 46 number. So this type of sexual reproduction needs partner, and it some organism which goes for sexual reproduction needs a special mechanism, meiosis. Okay, meiosis is a special type of cell division. Now, humans are those organisms which goes for sexual reproduction. So remember that every cell of our body which is not under the pressure of producing new organism like eyes, nose, kidneys, go for mitosis. Because it is not going to produce any new organism. Eye never produces new organism. Heart never produces new organism. Okay, so this is for organs. And we are having a special reproductive organ which produces gametes. So for sexual reproduction, we have to produce gamete. And for gamete production, we have to follow meiosis. And meiosis produces gametes. So one gamete come from father, which is known as sperm, and one gamete come from mother, which is known as egg. And when they fuse, they establish original number, that is 46 number of chromosome. And every cell of your body, eyes, kidneys, nose, digestive system, heart, is having number 46 number of chromosome. And it follows mitosis pattern. But special cells of your body, which are under the pressure, or which are committed to produce gamete, goes under the process of meiosis to produce gamete. So if you are a male, you will produce a sperm, and if you are a female, you will produce ova. And we will learn this pattern or reproduction in upcoming chapters. So you will know that how three types of cell division affects the mode of reproduction. We know that there are three types of cell division, and we know that how three types of cell division affects reproduction, asexual, and this goes for sexual.